But now, we're talking about how experience is always vital in enabling other people actually start in different fields. And for us in studio, we have Jeremy Onyango. Yes, you've been around, and we now just shift focus to you. Jeremy Onyango has been in Gor Mahia for 9 years. I didn't think there's no other player who's been in Gor Mahia for quite such a long period. Probably just tell us an overview. How has your life in Gor Mahia been ever since you joined Gor Mahia? And actually, where do you start even before joining Gor Mahia to be the person you are now, leading that side, being the captain? And now you're saying, yes, my life in Gor Mahia is almost done.
Actually, it has not been that easy. Mm. I was born in Kibera slums. I played for a team. These teams called Team Yamta, called Resimianto. From there, I joined KRA, Kenya Revenue Authority. That was in 2006. 2006 to 2008. 2008, I joined Gor Mahia from KRA. And I've had good times at Gor Mahia because I've won leagues. I've won 3 league cups. I've won top 8. I've won GoTV. And those are some of the wishes of a player, at least to win accolades. So the journey has not been that easy. It required a bit of hard work, determination, prayers, and thanks to all those virtues, I think I achieved what I was looking to.
I know for some time Gor Mahia didn't have a sponsor, and you were some of the players who were there at that time, probably. How was it at that time? Lacking fans at times, the players saying, no, we need to be paid, we want to play, and you, at that time, was the captain.
For sure it wasn't easy convincing the players that one of these days things will be okay. As you see now, things are so okay in Gor Mahia because we can afford to have like 2 sponsors at a time. But earlier in 2008, 2009, things were not that easy because there was no cash. As you know, fans were not in the stadium. So the office was the only sponsor of the club and maybe a part of the money from KPL. So we've come from far, and I really appreciate those who stood with the club all those years because most of the players who were being called upon to support the team, they turned down because they saw that there was nothing at the end of the day, and you could not even blame them because as you work, your family is expecting something on the table. So we fought, and at the end of the day, things started coming. Tuzo came on board from Tuzo. We've had so many sponsors on board, and as I talk right now, God is amongst the stable clubs, not only in Kenya, but the entire Africa.
Now, just talking about you being the captain, probably, has it been an easy journey? Because I'm aware that there's some time you even had to help other players maybe just be able to secure a fare because of the challenges when you guys never had that much money actually to utilize. How was that journey, you as a captain of the club?
For sure, being a captain of Gor Mahia is not that easy because guys will expect a lot from you. At times, convincing the players that today, just surrender a bit of your cash, knowing that tomorrow things will be okay. It has not been an easy journey. But me being the captain, I was able to keep them together, talk to them, telling them that don't worry, things will be okay. There are times results could not come our way, but I could convince them and talk to them that God is a big club, and as you know, our fans, the expectations, every now and then they're just expecting to win, 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 and win. So when you come to Gor Mahia, be ready of so many things. There are times they'll criticize you. There are times they'll talk good about you. So as a player, just take the criticisms positively and they'll make you move forward.
Yeah. And I know there's a lot that actually happens on the pitch, and people have actually been able to know a lot about you on the pitch. But off the pitch, I understand you've even decided now you need to go back to school. You've been studying, and now, just tell us about that.
Actually, I'm at St. Paul's University, Nairobi branch. I'm doing PR. Apart from that, I can call it a foundation. I have a foundation back at home called King Jerry Jagol Tournament. The reason as to why I started the tournament is that I've been going home. Our brothers are being taken for granted. Tournaments are being brought forward. At the end of the day, they're given like 2,000 shillings only, but there's cash. So those are some of the things that started pushing me. I came up with an idea. I talked to GoTV. They gave me some sponsorship. They gave me uniforms. They gave me some cash. Sort of that, at least in December, players were getting something at the end of the day, and some good cash and also uniforms. So thanks to that, that's why you're seeing I'm also coming into politics. Yeah.
We're going to be talking about
what you will be doing. But Okenye, I don't know, because we've had a lot of players actually who play and then they retire. You don't know where they've gone. You don't know what they're doing. They actually, their life in football becomes like a non-functioning marriage or something, for lack of a better term. What should these players do? Because now for Jerry, his time for Gourmet is probably, I wouldn't say almost over, because I know you might not be a player, but for some way you will be involved with the club. What do you expect to some of these players? They have been in the limelight for a number of years, and somewhere they just fade and their life becomes something different.
I think where we are currently, you know, the modern times that we are living in, and as Jerry has said, he's going back to school, he's working on other things that, you know, at the end of the day, you will not be playing until you are 100 or something. So you know that as a footballer, when you reach a certain age, the games will be minimal for you when it comes to playing. And then it will reach a certain point where you will no longer be playing. You'll quit, you know, football and probably move to something else. And for a while we've had, you know, footballers, not only footballers, but people in the sports world in general, being told to prepare for the future and not live for, you know, for the present only. Because we've had stories of people who were very popular back then. They had all at that time, but when, you know, the football career came to an end, things turned, you know, for the worse. So I think, as Jeremy said, you know, for anybody in sport, it's about, you know, preparing for the future at the present, so that when that career comes to an end, you have something else to go to.
Well, probably, Jerry, I know you've been able to do some things in Mashinani. We're going to be seeing that in a while. You've been able actually to bring different parties together, just play, enjoy the game, and maybe learn some few tips on that. Probably, what has been the biggest challenge now when it comes to matters of different players after retiring, after stopping playing? We now see how negative life actually it turns to be for them, and that's when you see guys saying, let's help someone with this money. There's a certain condition that he's facing, or you just go to the street, you see someone who you used to like and embrace so much while he used to be playing, but the life that he's leading is not that life a small kid should say, I want to be a footballer, so that after playing my playing career, I want to be like a certain person. What's the biggest challenge of that?
Okay, first of all, I think those are some of the reasons that are making Jerry Monyango to be who he is today. We are in a learning process, and you should learn from the past. You should learn from the other players. We've seen other players play, their names being said all over the country, they are being sung, but at the end of the day, when you meet them, when you are told that this is the player whom used to don the jersey of the national team, you can't imagine, because they are the same players whom they cannot even pay for the match. They are the same players whom cannot even put some food on the table for their families. So that's why Jerry Onyango wants to be a different person. That's why I went back to school. That's why I want to set my targets. And I did set my target, saying that one of these days I'll be amongst the best goalkeepers in Kenya. And as to me, I think that target, I reached that target, because in Kenya, I think when you come across and you count some of the goalkeepers who have performed so well in the country, then Jerry Monyango's name will be around. Apart from that, I think some of our footballers, some not only in football, but our life in general, when you don't utilize that time well, when you have it at that given time, then you'll never recover that time. Our new players right now, they have now that time. When I was joining GOR, there was no cash. Right now, you'll get players joining not only GOR, but big clubs. You're being paid like over 50,000 per month. Why don't you invest when you're earning such an amount of money? You get players, they're still living at their parents' home and they are getting all that money. That's when you'll get most of them misusing it, knowing that tomorrow I'll still get another chance. But if you're a footballer, one of these days you can get an injury that will keep you out for more than years. You just know our Kenyan clubs, some of them, they'll just throw you out what will happen to your life if you don't have other papers. So those are some of the things that are encouraging me, making me to be a different person from the other footballers. And I want also to leave a mark and show them an example that not only in football that you can make it, but also after leaving active football, you can also do other things that will help you in your life.
Yeah, there's a lot actually that a person can do when you finish your playing career. But for Jeremy Onyango, yes, he's been the coach for Gor Mahia.
Captain.
Calling you coach. I think my mind is thinking you might be a coach in the near future, so you never know, maybe they are in your plans. But yes, he's been the captain for Gor Mahia for quite a number of years. And for him, while still as a player, he was able actually to start a tournament, and that tournament actually has been able to aid different growing talent and nurture that talent. And it has also been an opportunity for where players can be capped and also nurtured for their talent development. So let's just take a look at what Jerry has been able to do in regards to that talent development in what is called his own tournament. Listen in.
For sure, it's a very big thing, because as you've seen now that each and every team is going to get a set of uniform, and they're also going to get balls. And apart from that, they're also going to be exposed, because we're having the media around. Their videos are going to go viral. So on that note, most of them are going to be seen by different clubs, and they'll move from Ugunza, and some of them will go even to play for the big club. So far, we have two players who are taking part in SportPesa Premier League, and thanks to that, at least at the end of the day, they're getting what they can bring onto the table for their families.
I think these tournaments actually, they always come hand in actually being able to put young developing talent actually on the spot. Has it been able to go that way for you?
For sure, it has. As you know now, right now, from my tournament, two players are playing in the SportPesa Premier League. That's Duncan, now he's playing for FC Leopards, and we have Juma, who is playing for Bandari. So that's an achievement. You've brought them from somewhere, and you've taken them somewhere. So as this King Jerry tournament is growing day by day, I'm very much sure that it's not only going to be a tournament, but we're going to have a solid team that will be taking part in a league back at home. And as things are moving by, I'm looking for a prospect whereby this time round they are also going to take part in the GoTV Shield tournament. So from there they'll get exposed and they'll get to learn more and gain more.
Do you think that we need to have more of different grassroots tournaments, and maybe we see sponsors that crop in just to be able to make these tournaments be bigger tournaments?
I think the tournaments come in handy, but sometimes, Moses, what I have against these tournaments is most of the time when we have tournaments, and especially we are in an election year, 2017 is an election year, politicians come up with these tournaments just to popularize themselves, you know, use the tournament for, you know, for themselves, and not, you know, you see lots of talent, people who come out to play in such tournaments. You see lots of talent, but at the end of the day, you have to ask yourself, yes, these people are very talented, but after this tournament, after winning this, you know, amount of money, what next for them? Probably I'd like to give it to Jerry that, you know, some of the players that have been scouted in his tournament have made it to the Kenya Premier League. That's a big achievement, you know. It's not easy for someone to move from the tournaments, the grassroots tournaments, and straight into the Premier League. So that's a big achievement for him. But if we have such tournaments and, you know, scouts are brought in from the big clubs that we have in the country, so that some of the players can be selected to go for trials to the big clubs, then it's a big achievement. But not having politicians use such tournaments just to popularize themselves.
Yeah, talking about politicians using the different tournaments to popularize themselves, yes, Jeremy Onyango has been a player for a number of years now, but he's saying it is my time to shift gears, and he wants to be those politicians that maybe Okenye is talking about. Yes, me saying that, yes, my focus, I want to go and vie for a certain seat. He's going to be telling us as much and more details on that after this very short break.